sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
At their own 23-yard line.
They'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Now Bridgewater. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. Well, it's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
So first and goal from the 9-yard line. Smith trying to run for it. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Ito Smith, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Extra point forthcoming.
For the point after.
It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead.
The score, Falcons 7, Panthers nothing. Sterling Hoffrichter to kick off for the
Falcons. Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
At the 26.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves them with third down and just a yard to go.
Brings up third and one.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. Uh-oh, he is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. That'll go down as just a 20-yard punt. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10.
38-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
And a Falcon.
Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number 3 man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
Brings up second and one.
Here's Ryan. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. From the gun, it's Ryan. His pass caught at the 4. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown.
Touchdown.
Julio Jones with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Falcons will extend their lead. And he'll bang that one through.
Score, Falcons 14. Panthers nothing.
Now following the touchdown, Hoff Richter to kick off. Taking it about the 1. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. This is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
1 yard gain.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stumped the run.
First carry for Mike Davis, the former Seahawk. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2.
Brings up 3rd and 7.
On 3rd down, Bridgewater. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The Panthers have the first. It's a gain of 12.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
On 1st and 10, Bridgewater. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The safety, Keanu Neal, there to knock that one free.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
An incomplete pass on 1st down, that leads to a 2nd and 10. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A gain of 13, it's a 1st down. Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play.
Brings up 2nd and 9. At the
run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9.
Let's go. Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike 45.
Bridgewater to throw it. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And the return stops at the 39-yard line.
By the Falcons.
First quarter, and now he already has 2 interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw 4 interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
And hit behind the line. He lost. across the football. It's loose. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S, ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock. But defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and trying not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Now he's hit, and Bridgewater loses the football. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
Catch here, left side, Thomas. And a good tackle there right around the 30. Stops him short of the first down. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
The roughing the kicker call on fourth down. What a big break. Leads to a first and 10. McCaffrey following the penalty. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
On the ground, McCaffrey. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches, you say, son, if you can darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Bridgewater to throw it this time. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on a final play of this first quarter. With 14-0 the score, this is the NFL on EA Sports. After the interception, here's Ryan. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Well, that one's all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
On second down now, it's Smith looking for a crease. Can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one. No gain. So they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
Brings up third down.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. He completes this to Russell Gage. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
A gain of 14
yards there and a Falcon first down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Now Ito Smith.
And the hole closes quickly.
He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
It's second and
well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
He's tackled
on any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And defensively going with a dime set, 6 DBs on 3rd and 4. From the shotgun, Ryan. That's complete to Smith. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
First down, Atlanta.
Now that's absolutely frustrating for a defender. Had a chance to get him on the ground before he got to the sideline, but what great vision and understanding where he is on the field as he headed for the marker and picked up the first down.
And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, and tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last 2 plays. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now the first carry for Brian Hill. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side. When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Now it's Ryan. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Julio Jones, his Pro Bowl receiver, but it'll be second and goal. Down this close to the goal line, first down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball first down in this situation.
And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Brian Hill, his second touchdown on the season. And the Falcons push further out in front. Boy, so if you are scoring at home, Charles, and God bless you if you are, but that's now 3 drives and 3 touchdowns.
So in a baseball game, wouldn't that wreak havoc on your scorecard?
Yes.
I mean, with all the action that's happening now, how they got here, whatever cliche you want to bring into it, they're locked into a groove, they're clicking on all cylinders. Bottom line, they're piling up the points.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3 and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
On second down, Bridgewater again. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a 4th pick. And it's 3rd down.
Brings up 3rd down.
The Panthers on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 10. And now the 3rd down throw incomplete as well. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's 4th down.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. Taken from just outside the 30. It'll be a net of 39. 41-yard punt, two on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Atlanta.
It's a gain of 34.
Big plays are starting to become the trend here in this first half, and everything that they've tried has worked, and there's another example right there.
So a big play as it gets them all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. On the draw, this is Smith. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
So from the 17, here's second and 7. Operating from the gun, Ryan. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Eli Apple. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And 11 at the 19-yard line.
Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
And there's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC, as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football. Whether you hand it to him, throw it to him out of the backfield, just imagine if they had the guts to let him return kicks as well. This guy is a true triple threat.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10.
Let's go, D.
From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Isaiah Oliver with the INT. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10. at the 50.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And the Panthers will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory.
At their own 13-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
At the 12-yard line.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Here's Bridgewater. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24. 13 yards on the pickup, and it will result in a fresh set of downs. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
He's going to look deep down the field and unable to connect on the long pass. He actually brings it in, but he was out of bounds, incomplete. Boy, he's got to have that wrong, doesn't he? They declined that.
There's no doubt about it. Sorry to step on you there, partner, but let's go ahead and run this one together, right? Incomplete pass, yet they call pass interference, and somehow you're going to decline that
pass. I'm so confused. The throw over the middle taken in, and they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 20-yard line. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
First down, Atlanta.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he'll hit his tight end, Walker. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Looking to throw again on second down. Ryan.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And those two just haven't been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
Again, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. To throw again is Ryan. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry?
And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Ito Smith, his second touchdown of the night. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Richter to kick off for the Falcons.
Now following the touchdown, Hoff Richter to kick off. This will be fielded inside the five. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. More muscle up front for this second and two. They've got three tight ends out there. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Christian McCaffrey, the ball.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
I
see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
Let's put him on the buses. Let's put that team on the bus. Mike 54. Mike 54.
Bridgewater from the gun on third down. To the right side and complete to Thomas. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. That'll go as a punt of 42, 7 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time out, another touchdown. I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with
you. Oh, it's out. Smith lost it. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. But he has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
Trying to get the run game going. Here's Davis. He's able to get six. A nice pickup down to the 21.
The ball carrier.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Well, coming into this one, we expected that this offense would have trouble with this defense, and that's exactly the way that this game has gone. Pressure in his face, coverage downfield has been tight. That led to another incompletion. This defense, they're exactly who we thought they were coming into this one.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. From the gun, Bridgewater. The third down battle won by Atlanta's defense. Solid coverage.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
And this one is right through. And that drops a deficit from 28 to 25. Kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white flag and just want to get out of here? Yeah, I think you got to go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Here's Smith to return it. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punch in the end zone without turning it over.
Play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. From the gun, Ryan. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
The Falcon First down.
Well, I certainly don't want to pile on, but this defense has just not been up to the challenge in this game, and this continues as we see here. Coverage not been very good, soft in spots. There's an easy throw and catch for another first down.
They'll go with Hill here on first down, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Brought down by Trey Boston.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Operating from the gun, Ryan. That one complete to Hill. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
First down, Falcons.
One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a shotgun handoff to Hill. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Now I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game.
It's a first down on a gain of 10. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And Jones has it over the middle. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A gain of six there on first.
Brings up second and four at the 12-yard line.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. From the gun, it's Ryan. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll be out of bounds. The Falcon passing game looking good on this drive as they get the first down.
Tell you what, partner, the way he's been slinging in this one, I think he should be ticketed for a baseball cap and a set of headphones for the next drive. He's been absolutely sensational. But one thing we've both learned about quarterbacks in this league, they often stay on the field longer than you expect.
Throw again, and he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown.
Touchdown,
Julio Jones. His second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year. And this offense is running away with this one. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that will extend this big lead. Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on down here in this fourth quarter.
This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22.
He was taken down.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and seven.
Now it's the backup, Greer. Steps away to his left. Now he'll pull it down. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half.
Nope.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. This is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a cornerback. This is a linebacker.
Does this feel to you like he's having a flashback? Because a lot of these linebackers we see in the NFL, in high school, they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time. It's like he said to himself, let's go back and put on the letter jacket and go get the football. How about this one? Three interceptions thus far.
Brian Hill. In on the stop, it's Tahir Whitehead.
He was tackled at
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 27 yards there, a first down.
27 on the play, and a Falcon first down.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, and it's intercepted. He was trying to get it to Ridley. Picked off by Eli Apple. The 40, the 30, the 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell, just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that will cut this lead down to 25. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
At their own 17-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And it's all but certain that this win streak is going to extend another week. Just another tremendous performance in this one. And all the way down to the 40-yard line. A big-time play there for the Falcons. 43 yards on the ground.
First down, Falcons.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. They go play action now. Ryan. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Shaq Thompson making his presence felt on the sack. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Charles, did I just hear that right? They declined the personal foul. 3 yards, they just declined them.
And I have to think that the official is thinking to himself, did I just hear that correctly, that you declined that one? All I can think of is that someone on the field got confused. It had to, because you're going to take the yards on that penalty each and every time.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown.
Touchdown.
Brian Hill. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Falcons continue to pour it on. Two now for the point after. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Falcons 42, Panthers 10. Sterling Hoffrichter to kick off for the Falcons.
Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Now the throw pulled in by Anderson. Anderson loses the football, and the Falcons grab it, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try and be simple this time and succinct. It simply has not been their night.
No, I think that fumble's kind of indicative of how this whole evening's gone, isn't it?
Without a doubt. I mean, they've tried, but nothing has ever really taken throughout the game. That's why they're down so big.
Now a 10th carry for Hill. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
The Falcons on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On third down, here's Hill. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. Call it a gain of 3, and it'll bring up 4th down. The Falcons send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. Oh, it's a wobbler here. And a fair catch called for and made at the 12-yard line. Not good at all. Punt of just just 24 yards there. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
And they take a knee.
Tonight's
a big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Falcons, they continue to cruise through this first half of the schedule as they move to 8-0 now on the campaign. And now they'll get the weekend off as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, things are kind of getting ugly as they drop to 1-7 now on the year. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to KC to take on the Chiefs. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon saying so long, everybody.